In this video, we are going to discuss left-sided congestive heart failure in dogs. The information presented here is based on the work of Dr. Rebecca Gumpt. This presentation is possible due to a collaboration between Community Animal Clinic of South Paulding and Veterinary Channel. Left heart failure occurs when the left side of the heart is no longer working properly and cannot pump blood effectively to the body. Blood accumulates in the lungs and interferes with the ability of oxygen to enter the bloodstream. If left heart failure is not treated, or if the patient does not respond to treatment, then death may occur from the accumulation of blood in the lungs. The causes of left heart failure in dogs are the following: atrioventricular valve degeneration of the left mitral valve, bacterial endocarditis, an infection of either the aortic or mitral valve, dilated cardiomyopathy, a disease of the heart muscle in large breed dogs that results in a big, flabby heart. Dilated cardiomyopathy is uncommon in small breeds of dogs. Congenital heart defects, particularly a patent ductus arteriosus and sometimes a ventricular septal defect or mitral valve dysplasia. Systemic hypertension is an uncommon cause of left-sided congestive heart failure in dogs. Dogs with left heart failure cannot exercise, they cough when lying down, and they may get up and pace after lying down. As clinical signs progress, they eventually start breathing faster, sometimes more than 50 times per minute, and with more effort. A loud heart murmur is a common finding in physical examination. Dogs with severe distress may require stabilization before diagnostic tests are performed to evaluate the heart and other organs that depend on normal heart function. Routine diagnostics test to evaluate the patients presenting the clinical signs associated with heart failure are the following: thoracic and abdominal radiographs, echocardiogram, electrocardiogram, especially if an irregular heart rhythm is detected during physical examination, blood tests including a complete blood count, biochemical profile, and heartworm test, urinalysis. If the dog has moderate to severe left heart failure, it may be hospitalized for stabilization with injectable diuretics, such as furosemide, the sodalator drugs, such as nitroglycerin ointment, hydralazine, or sodium nitroprusside. If the dog has mild heart failure, it may be managed on an outpatient basis. Dogs with left heart failure are very fragile and need aggressive treatment with as little stress as possible. Once the dog is stable and breathing is improved, long-term medications are started, such as the following. A diuretic, as per example furosemide, is usually continued indefinitely and combined with other diuretics, such as spironolactone. Dosages are adjusted to the lowest ones that keep the dog out of heart failure. ACE inhibitors such as enalapril, benazepril, or ramipril may be used to improve the quality of life and help to reduce fluid retention by the body. The effect of ACE inhibitors is not immediate, but they exert modest positive effects over weeks to months. Pimobendan is a drug that acts as a vasodilator to relieve the workload of the heart and to increase the force of contractions. Pimobendan is commonly used with other medications such as diuretics and ACE inhibitors. Digoxin is used in some dogs that have moderate to severe heart failure and very fast heart rates, secondary to abnormal rhythms such as atrial fibrillation. Beta blockers such as carvedilol can improve the quality of life in dogs with atrioventricular valve degeneration. Beta blockers are also used to slow the heart rate secondary to atrial fibrillation. Occasionally, other classes of drugs, such as calcium channel blockers, may be needed to control the elevated heart rate caused by atrial fibrillation. In addition to drug therapy, a low-salt diet may be used to limit salt intake. Although strenuous exercise should be avoided, mild exercise may be done based on the guidelines of the veterinary cardiologist. Intensive monitoring is often needed during hospitalization. Laboratory tests, chest radiographs, and other diagnostics are often repeated until the dog is stable. Follow-up visits are usually scheduled with 5 to 14 days after discharge. Recheck visits may include thoracic radiographs and blood work. The interval between visits and further diagnostics depends on the underlying disease and how the patient is responding to treatment. Periodic monitoring is needed for the life of the dog. The dog's owner should notify the veterinarian if any signs of heart failure return while the dog is taking medications. The prognosis for this condition is variable. Dogs with left-side heart failure can live from days to years, with the prognosis depending on the cause and the severity of the heart failure. For more information about this condition, please visit Community Animal Clinic of South Paulding. We are located at 105 Brownsville Road in the city of Powder Springs, Georgia. Our telephone number is 678-401-4588.